안녕하세요, 여러분. Hello, everyone. I'm Spencer. 저는 Spencer라고 합니다. Today I'm going to talk about some more Korean movies. 오늘도 한국 영화에 대해서 얘기해 보겠습니다. I'm going to talk about their titles in Korean and English. 한국어 제목이랑 영어 제목 비교하고, and I will also talk about their posters. 포스터도 비교하고, as well as the famous lines from the movies. 그리고 명대사까지 번역해 보겠습니다. 그리고 오늘 영화 다 공포 영화입니다. All the movies today are horror movies. And the three movies I will talk about today are 곡성, The Wailing, Hashtag 살아있다, Alive, and lastly, 부산행, Train to Busan. 그럼 재미있게 끝까지 보시고 구독하고 좋아요 눌러주세요. Please watch to the end and remember to like and to subscribe. Let's get started. 시작합시다. 오늘은 첫 번째 얘기할 영어는 The first movie I will talk about today is 곡성, The Wailing. So the English title is The Wailing. If you directly translate 곡성, then it would be whale. Or the whale, or maybe wailing cry. So it means that it's a very noisy, sudden cry or scream. But 이 제목은 아쉬운 점 하나 있어요. 영화 세팅에는 시골 이름은 곡성입니다. 그래서 당연히 번역하고 싶으면 그두 가지 이미 whale, 이렇게 whale 하고 그 시골 이름까지 번역해 보는 거 되게 어렵죠. 그래서 이해하는데 그래도 조금 아쉽죠. So the Korean title is obviously better for this movie since it has more than one meaning within it, and the English title just cannot have both meanings of the village and of wailing, screaming. This movie came out in 2016, and the director is Na Hong-jin, and he is also the writer. And it is starring a large cast, but the main cast is Kwak Do-won, he is the police officer. Hwang Young-min, great actor, he is the shaman. So a shaman is the person who does rituals like he does. And then Chun Woo-hee, she is Mumyeong. So she is the kind of deranged woman. Deranged means a little bit crazy, like she has some kind of mental problem, and she's dressed all in white in the film. So this film is a horror film, 공포 영화입니다, about a police officer investigating mysterious killings, right? Mysterious because they can't find evidence or clear clues about who is the killer. And it's in a mountainous village. Mountainous은 그냥 산이 많은 시골 뜻입니다. 산이 많은, mountainous. And the village is called 곡성. And the police officer is trying to save his daughter. So the English and Korean poster for 곡성 is quite different. 한국 포스터는 그 배우들이 얼굴 다 포함되는 포스터이고, 그리고 영어 포스터는 아예 배우 없이 그냥 그 세팅만 보여줘요. This might be because the actors are well recognized in Korea, but might not be as well recognized in English-speaking countries. But I also think that the English poster is a little creepier. 그래서 이런 영화는 공포 영화다. 그 영어 포스터는 조금 더잘 표현하는 것 같아요. Maybe they wanted their audience to know more clearly what they were getting into, right? 그 시청자들이 좀 직접적으로 이거 무서운 영화다, 공포 영화다 이렇게 알아주고 싶었던 것 같아요. 그럼 명대사 봅시다. Let's take a look at one of the famous lines. So this line is said to the police officer about his daughter. 자네는 낚시를 헐 적에 무엇이 걸어 나올지 알고 허나 그 놈은 그냥 미끼를 던져본 것이고 자네 딸내미는 그것을 확 물어본 것이야. there's a little bit of 사투리 in this quote. I don't want to explain too much about the quote because there's a bit of a spoiler. But anyway, it's saying that things that happened were not on purpose. It was kind of a coincidence that she was the one who took the bait or fell for the trap. So she wasn't targeted, it just happened by coincidence. The next film is 살아있다, or alive. So the direct translation is the same, nothing is changed here. #까지 다 포함했습니다. It's a very trendy title, right? Since basically everyone is using SNS, right?
뭐 대부분 사람들이 다 SNS 하고 계셔서 되게 좀 현대적인 제목인 것 같아요.
And this film was released this year, so 2020. And the director is Jo Il-hyung. And it has a lot of writers. So the writers were Lee Yoo-jin, Oh Hyo-jin, Kim Gae-mi, and Kim Se-rong. And it's starring one of my favorite actors.
제가 좋아하는 남자 배우 중에 하나 주인공입니다. 바로 유아인입니다.
So Yoo-ah-in is the main male character. In the film, he's Oh Jun-woo. And then I also love the female main character.
여배우도 엄청 좋아하는 배우인데 바로 박신혜입니다.
And in the movie, she is Kim Yoo-bin.
이 영화는 좀비 나온 공포 영화입니다.
This is a zombie film. And I don't usually like zombie films.
제가 좀비 영화 좋아하는 편이 아니지만 근데 이 영화 약간 조금 fresh하게 뭔가 신선하게 만들었으니까 되게 재밌게 봤습니다.
And this film was based on a script by Matt Naylor. And he co-adapted, so together with the director, he adapted the script for the film. A sudden zombie apocalypse forces a young video game streamer, Yoo-ah-in, in the film, to try to survive in his apartment complex, and he meets Park Shin-hye along the way. So apocalypse is the end of the world. So here it's a zombie apocalypse. The zombies are making the end of the world happen. There were some similar posters. So this English poster also has a Korean poster that's the same version. But the Korean poster I chose here, I really love. And I didn't find this poster in English as much as the other poster. So I really love the Korean poster. 그 한국 포스터는 되게 재미있게 만들었던 것 같아요. It's kind of a modern day problem of trying to get reception.
휴대폰 안 되니까 더 멀리 이렇게 해봤는데 그리고 뒤에는 엄청 무서운 좀비들이 엄청 꽉 찼어요.
So it's kind of very entertaining and intriguing, right?
더 알고 싶어요.
In the case of this English poster, it's kind of in the action.
그래서 뭔가 이 영화는 좀 액션 많을 것 같다. 그래서 이 포스터도 괜찮은 것 같아요.
It's a movie that looks very action-packed. Both posters, I think, successfully show that excitement.
그런 긴장감 잘 약간 만든 것 같아요. 그럼 명대사 하나 봅시다.
So the line is, 살아남으면 그때 희망이 보인대요.
그러니까 먼저 살고 봐요.
So if you survive, that's when you see hope. So first of all, just try to survive.
이 명대사에서 여러 가지 살아남다, 살고 보다, 그리고 제목 살아있다, 살고 있다 이런 여러 가지 단어 있잖아요. 그래서 한번 영어로 정리해 보겠습니다. 살아남다.
This means survive. Survive.
살고 보다.
Try to survive. Try to survive.
살아있다.
Alive. Alive.
살고 있다.
Alive or living. Alive or living. And 살다. Live. Live. So you can see in English as well, there are different vocabulary words that you should know.
그럼 마지막 영화는 바로 부산행입니다.
The English title is Train to Busan. Here, if you directly translate Busan Heng, it would just be to Busan, right? Train 얘기는 안 나오죠. 직접 번역하면. 예를 들면 영어 제목은 그냥 to Busan, train 없이 to Busan이라고 부르면 그 nuance 이해할 수 없을 거예요. What I mean is it's not clear if it's by transportation or if it's by foot. It's not clear like it is in Korean. So it's better to say train to Busan. This film was released in 2016. The director is Yeon Sang-ho and there are two writers, Lee Dong-ha and Jang Kyung-ik. It is starring Gong Yoo. I really love Gong Yoo as well. Gong Yoo 되게 좋아하는데요. And he plays Seo Seok-woo. He's the main character in the film. But there are a lot of great supporting actors and the list goes on. So it's kind of an endless list. It's a star-studded cast. Star-studded cast means it's full of stars. And it's an action horror zombie film, right? Action zombie 공포 영화입니다. And similar to 살아있다. 살아있다랑 비슷하게, it's about a zombie apocalypse. The apocalypse breaks out as the main characters are on a train from Seoul to Busan. And they have to try to survive. Posters are very similar. The difference is that the English poster has fewer actors. 영어 포스터는 그냥 공유 주인공이랑 그 주인공의 딸만 나와요. I think they wanted to put the spotlight on him, but 그 한국 포스터 조금 더 좋은 것 같아요. 왜냐면 엄청 큰 캐스트지만 유명한 배우들이 꽉 찼는데 그거 안 보여주는 거 약간 아쉬운 것 같아요. 그리고 영어 포스터도 바로 그 기차 두 개 보여주죠. I think they want to clearly show what the setting of the film is. 한국 포스터 경우에는 바로 안 보여도 뒤에 있죠. And it shows a lot more kind of destruction. It feels more like apocalypse than the English poster. One of the lines I really like, 좋아하는 명대사 하나 있는데요. 아빠들은 원래 맨날 욕먹고 인정 못 받고 그래도 뭐 희생하고 사는 거지. 안 그래? Well, this is saying, right, everyday fathers get yelled at, they get scolded, and they don't get respected, right? 인정 못 받고. But it's a sacrifice, isn't it? 재밌게 잘 보셨습니까? Did you enjoy the video? Please remember to like and subscribe and turn on the alarm notification. 구독하고 좋아요 그리고 알람 설정까지 해주세요. 그리고 추천해줄 수 있는 영화 있으면 댓글 부탁드립니다. I love getting movie recommendations. So please tell me some movie recommendations in the comments. 다음에 봐요. See you next time.